houses. Gresham Smith and Partners are a large multidisciplinary architect engineering firm, and her presentation is going to be on culture change through the environmental management system. Thank you.
Great, thanks. Well, we all know that Iowa is a hotbed for political activity right now. But what you may not know is Iowa is also the first state in the nation to recognize that mandatory waste diversion goals for landfills may not necessarily lead us to achieve the sustainability goals that we need to related to managing our landfills as a resource. So what did Iowa decide to do about it? How did this come about? A few years back, the landfills in the state were required to meet mandatory waste diversion goals, which was interesting because if you were a small agency out in the rural part of the state, it was difficult to meet those goals. You didn't have the resources, how were you going to set up recycling? But if you were a large city, you could meet those goals, but once you met the waste diversion goals, there was no incentive to do more. And the other part of it is if you didn't meet your goals, you had to pay an additional penalty to the state. So what they had was a situation where some people were meeting it, some people weren't, some were paying penalties into the state, some weren't, but overall they really weren't meeting their goals as a state. So they recognized they needed a better way. And so what the legislature did was put in a new program, voluntary, that if a landfill or waste solid waste agency decided to implement an environmental management system, that they would get out of the mandatory waste diversion goals, they wouldn't have to pay the penalty anymore, and they would have access to additional grants, they would get training, they would have access to DNR staff to help them, and they could set their own goals for their landfill. The key was that this program not only focused on waste diversion, such as recycling and household hazardous waste, but it also focused on other environmental impacts of the landfill that were important to the state, such as greenhouse gases, water quality, environmental education. So they go from mandatory in one area of the landfill to voluntary goals across a number of different environmental impacts for the landfill. Essentially, what is an EMS and what did they have to do? It's the business system of plan, do, check, act as applied to the environment. So the agency has to adopt an environmental policy. They have to look at how their landfill impacts the environment or their other operations at their landfill, such as transfer stations. They have to identify all their legal and other requirements. They have to set environmental objectives and targets around those six areas of interest. They have to identify work plans and action plans on how they're going to achieve their goals. They have to identify roles and responsibilities for their staff. They have to communicate it, not only to their staff, but to the public. They have to train. Going into check, they have to monitor and measure their progress. If they're not meeting a goal, they have to ask themselves why not. They have to do an audit every year, and audit not only their compliance requirements, but also audit, are they really meeting the EMS goals? Do their staff know about their goals? Are their staff implementing the goals? And finally, they have to look back at the whole system and say, is it doing what we expect as an organization? Are we making progress? Are we continually improving? And if not, why not? So the state and the legislature were smart. They decided to start it with a pilot program. They selected six solid waste agencies from across the state. They selected very small agencies. The smallest agency we worked with had a staff of five, all the way up to the Des Moines agency, which has a staff of over 100. And these six pilots were walked through Plan, Do, Check, Act, the EMS, over a period of 1 year. And that was concluded about a year ago. What were the results? Well, here's an example program that was done by Scott County, and it brings the whole EMS and what it can achieve to one point. So they decided shingle recycling was an important component of what they needed to achieve for the landfill. They set a target to increase recycling 20% by July 1st, 2011, and they put in an action plan. Not only are we just going to set this goal, but we're going to go educate people on it. We're going to tell them what we're trying to do and how we're going to do it. They developed incentives. They had workshops. They secured grinding services. And then they quantified the results and went out and marketed the program. So you can see the whole part of the EMS coming together in just one of this one objective and target that they set, and the results are there. They increase recycling by a substantial amount in a very short period of time as a result of this program. The other thing that Scott County did was really got their employees involved. And they came up with an acronym called PROTECT, which really represented their environmental policy and their safety programs. They went out to their employees, asked them what they thought about the environment, things that they could do, how they could make themselves better. And then they published it, and they put posters around their offices, just making sure everyone knew as an agency what they were trying to do for the environment and how everyone could be involved. So where does it go from here? We've had, as I mentioned, six agencies have been through this very successfully. The numbers speak for themselves. There's a final report documenting all the improvements in greenhouse gases, water quality, recycling, environmental ed. And now the state has accepted two more solid waste agencies into the program. We kicked off with them a couple months ago. And the goal is to hopefully move the 44 agencies in the state towards this EMS approach on a voluntary basis, but getting them all working together for the future. And I think it's summed up well by what Brian Seals at Scott County said. EMS is about making environmental stewardship and second nature. It's everyone's job here. So I'll just close by saying Kathy Morris, who is the executive director of Scott County, who is part of this, is in the audience and would be happy to answer your questions at the end.